Here's your Storm Tracker weather forecast with meteorologist Mike Hurd.
Still got this ribbon of air that's got a lot of subtropical moisture following the polar jet stream up and over the top of this high pressure ridge. This atmospheric river is going to bring quite a bit of moisture through the Pacific Northwest. It's already advancing moisture out here towards Edmonton and Calgary, and it's slowly working its way eastward and is going to be digging down into western, southern, and central Montana overnight and into tomorrow morning. Snow showers increasing towards Butte and back towards Missoula at this hour. So there are a lot of advisories and warnings from central Idaho back into Washington State, but the majority of the winter weather highlights are back here across western, southwestern, and southern Montana down into Yellowstone National Park. So as we break it down from the National Weather Service, they have a winter storm warning out now through early Friday morning above 5,500 feet. Mountains and passes highly impacted with the storm. They're expecting around 10 to 12 inches for most mountain passes, but you get above mountain pass level up around 7,000-8,000 feet, there could be 1 to 3 feet of snow in those higher elevations around southwest Montana. That could increase some avalanche danger. There could be some locally gusty winds with this as well, and there could be some pockets of blowing snow. Now you get below 5,000 feet in our lower valleys, we're expecting some accumulating snow, gusty winds, and some wintry travel concerns, but there's a lot of warm air with this, and there is the potential for rain or rain snow mix tomorrow afternoon. If so, the accumulations may not be as high as what we're projecting, but watch out for some slushy roadways, and those wet roads will become iced over basically tomorrow afternoon, evening, and into Friday morning. So as you look at the high resolution forecast model, it's increasing the aerial coverage of snow overnight into early tomorrow morning. So bigger impacts for that morning commute tomorrow from Bozeman Pass into Bozeman down towards West Yellowstone and Big Sky, and then back out here towards Butte and the mountain passes around McDonald Pass, Anaconda, Georgetown Lake. That's all filling in throughout the day tomorrow. But there is some dry air entrained in this as well. So some of the valleys like around Dillon, possibly back up towards Whitehall, may not see quite as much or a rain snow mix through a better part of the day tomorrow. But it's just sitting here all day long. And in fact, tomorrow night as the colder air moves in, it becomes more widespread, even reaching some of the lowest of valleys. And this could be another travel hazard Thursday night into early Friday morning. It does fall apart by Friday afternoon, but there's still some pockets of mountain snow in there. And then another fast-moving storm system is likely to develop as we look out into Saturday. So snowfall numbers, again, are highly varied, and they continue to go up and down a little bit here and there. Lesser impacts from Dillon southward, but Butte, you're in that 4 to 6 inch range. And boy, the model's being very aggressive for Bozeman, and it just depends on the air temperature. If we get in the lower 40s, we won't see quite that much, but I do think 6 to 8 inches is a strong possibility. And again, higher elevations, we'll see more snow. So the snow beginning to fill in Butte, as we saw on radar, 31 degrees right now. And as you look at Bozeman's temperatures, we're sitting at 30 degrees. And again, it's a little bit on the windy side. Teens, 20s, 30s around the state of Montana. There were a few lower 40s in there a short time ago. Increasing snow, increasing wind. Temperatures not as cold. We got 20s and 30s in there tomorrow, hovering in that low to mid 30 range. A few lower 40s are possible here and there, but definitely a snowy day tomorrow. And again, it could mix with a little bit of rain in the afternoon. Snow showers increasing here. I got teens and 20s. Snow showers pretty much all day long, 20s and 30s. So as you look at the extended forecast, we try and keep the numbers slightly above freezing. So that's going to do a couple of things. That could bring some minor melting or keep roadways on the wet side that will ice up. And again, those slushy roads could be icy Thursday night into Friday morning. But look at the colder weather moving in next week. Highs and lows with a little bit of Arctic air about this time next week. Butte, a solid chance for snow Thursday, Friday. A few snow showers on Saturday. And again, looks like a little colder weather pattern next week. A little bit of snow for Dillon. Shouldn't be major, but minor accumulations are possible. And again, trending colder. And for West Yellowstone, high probability of snow Thursday, Friday, Saturday. And colder with more snow next week.
All right, and actually we need to bring something up. Today is National Weather Person's Day.
I had
to remind
you
again. And what better way to celebrate than a lot of snowy weather?
There you go.
It's great, right?
Yeah, great.
When's National News Anchors Day?
I know, we don't know. We haven't figured that out yet, so we're not really sure.
All right, up next on MTN News, Nick Petrocioni has sports and it's National Signing Day.